Hello friends, this is Dr. Hemchand Kothari from eResearch Academy. Friends, today I am going to discuss various types of research with appropriate examples. This topic is very important from UGC NET and other competitive examinations point of view, where questions from research aptitude are asked. So please watch complete video, because at the end of this video series I have designed some MCQs on types of research. So friends, let's start with the various types of research. The first type of research that I am going to discuss here is the basic research. It is a scientific research which is conducted to enhance and improve existing knowledge of different fields so that understanding of a particular subject could be improved and future prediction could be done. Basic research is also known as fundamental and pure research. So this is very important question that is asked many times in examination. Which of the following research is also known as fundamental or pure research? So your answer must be basic research. If we talk about the example of this kind of research, the very first example is how universe is expanding. Okay, if we answer how this universe is expanding and whatever the conclusion will come out, this will be the result of basic research, and this is generally known as this expanding of universe and the theory thereon, that is Big Bang theory. The next example is how does sweet drink causes obesity. Here if we talk about whether the sweet drinks causes obesity or not, so this will become the causal research. This research we will discuss further in this video. But here we are talking how these sweet drinks causes the obesity. So this kind of research is also known as the basic research. The next type of research that I am going to discuss here is applied research. It is a research that follows a systematic inquiry which involves practical application of science. As the name suggests, in this research, specific knowledge acquired through the basic research applied to solve a practical problem immediately. So in this research, we apply the particular skill, knowledge, tools, technique to solve the practical problem immediately. And these tools, these techniques may be acquired through the basic or pure research. If we talk about the example of this kind of research, so the first example is, if a plant head is identifying and controlling the factors causing for production downfall, so this kind of research will be considered as applied research, because here the plant head is applying some skills, some pre-acquired knowledge here, while identifying and controlling the factors which are causing for the downfall in the production. So this will be considered as the applied research. Second example, if any treatment method is applied to reduce the anxiety of the employee, so this will again consider as the applied research, because here some methods are being applied to reduce the anxiety level of the employee. Applied research is also known as action research. Action research is research that focuses in an immediate solution of local problem. It is generally conducted by a practitioner. So here one thing that we have to note, that it focuses on immediate solution of some local problems. If we take the example here, the first example is patient treated by a medicine practitioner is the example of action research. Here the practitioner is taking action to cure the patient. The second example is, if fishes of any pond infected by a particular fungi, then aqua scientist will treat them by giving a dose of 0.5 ppm KMNO4, that is potassium permanganate. And by this way, he or she will cure to that infected fishes. So this is again a type of action research where the aqua scientist is taking an action for curing the fishes. The third kind of example, that is if there is any disease in any crop which is diagnosed and cured by an agri scientist, then again he took an action against this disease and cure it. So it will be also considered as action research. If you talk about the fields of the action research, so there are so many fields where the action research is applied, but here I am talking about the academics. If we want to study the need and interest of the student studying in different courses or classes, and accordingly if we have to take any action, so this will also come under the action research. The next example is, or field is, the problem of classroom discipline of students, problem of student attendance, improvement of syllabus or a curriculum. If whatever the action we take for getting the solution of all these problems, this will come under the action research. The next example is Atal Twinkling Lab. So Atal Twinkling Lab is the initiative taken by the Indian government for enhancing the drawing ability or creativity inside of the student studying in a junior high school. Okay, so here again government is taking action to improve the creativity among the students. Next example is Ishan Uday and Ishan Vikas. Ishan Uday and Ishan Vikas is a joint scheme of UGC and MHRD. So this is again an important question for the paper first in UGC NET 2018 examination. Ishan Uday and Ishan Vikas Yojana or scheme is for which of the following? So you will have to answer that to enhance or to increase the level of higher education in North Indian region. So this will be the answer of this question. So government here has taken an action to increase the level of higher education in North India region and has initiated this scheme Ishan Uday and Ishan Vikas. So under this scheme, government is providing scholarship to the student who have just passed their 10+2 for their higher education. The exploratory research. Exploratory research is a research which is conducted to explore new things or to find a new scope. More precisely, it is a research which aims to have familiarity with place or a particular phenomena. In exploratory research, the researcher has a very small amount of information. Again, very important point that is. And on the basis of this small amount of information, he or she wants to explore it in detail for the better understanding about the problem and its solution. So in exploratory research, we have to explore the new things, and these new things are explored on the basis of a small amount of information, and this small amount of information helps to the researcher to explore in the detail for the better understanding of the problem and the solution. If we take the example, here we can say about the mobile company. To increase the number of customers or to launch any scheme or to penetrate in any region, the mobile company has to explore this region first. Once they explore the region, once they explore the opportunities, once they identify these opportunities, then they start working on this area. Okay. So if we talk about the second example, this is about the all government surveys. Government used to conduct the surveys to explore the things, to explore the problem, to identify the problem first. And then, if once the problems are identified, things are explored, then government take the further action. The next type of research that I am going to discuss here is the descriptive research. Descriptive research is a research that aims to describe the present phenomena. It is the research that answers the question what, when, where, how much and how many. So this is very important to note here. Under the descriptive research, we answer what, where, when, how much and how many, but does not answer why and how. So by this way, it becomes a very important question that under which study we answer what, when, where, how much and how many. So your answer will be descriptive research. Descriptive research is also known as ex post facto research. Ex post facto research here mean after the facts that has occurred. So what does it mean? If some facts that has occurred and then we are just investigating upon how much it occurred, when it occurred, where it occurred, then it will be known as the descriptive research or ex post facto research. It is also a quasi experimental research. This can also be asked in your examination in any form. If you talk about the example, the Census of India is the best example of this type of research, because in after every 10 years this census is taken. Next one is, how many people got affected by recent flood in Kerala? Here again we are answering the question how many. So this kind of research is also known as the descriptive research. If anybody study there and try to identify how many people were affected with this Kerala flood, it will come under the descriptive research.